Welcome, everybody. Brother Dan Goodwin here, Prophecy in the News, here with a brief update for you today. And, of course, you know that they asked me to come by and share some things with the ministry. And I'm tickled to death. I'm Brother Dan Goodwin. God's Final Jubilee Ministries is who I am. And we love Prophecy in the News. And I just wanted to share a little update with you today about what's going on. You know, the word rapture is not in the Bible, is it? There's a lot of confusion today, and a lot of people talking about the fact that, you know, well, there's no the rapture's not even in the Bible. Well, I got news for you. The rapture is in the Bible. Maybe the word rapture's not in the Bible. That doesn't mean the principle or the concept of the rapture's not in the Bible. For instance, do you believe in the Trinity? Father, Son, Holy Spirit? Do you believe in the triune God? Of course you do. Did you know the word Trinity is not in the Word of God? Hey, do you believe the Bible? Did you know the word Bible is not in the Bible? Doesn't mean it's not a concept, right? You get where I'm getting with this? In my book, 7 Clocks of Ticking, brand new book, you can get it at prophecynews.com. That just came out, I mean, just days ago. This is hot off the press, and we're having a hard time keeping up, getting them printed, but Prophecy News has them right now. If you go to the phone number on the screen or go to the website, but I want to share with you something in this book about the rapture. And I'm not going to share it all, but I'm just going to give you a little tidbit here. It's called The Rapturous Jewel. And I think it's the first chapter in the book, in the first half of the book, about the 7 clocks. The second half's about the 7 clocks. The first half is some jewels of prophecy to help you understand before you get to the 7 clocks. And so a rapture's jewel, let me read a little bit of this. And this is right out of the book that I printed off here. I'm going to read just a little bit for you to help you understand this. I want you to understand that there is a rapture. The word rapture is not in the Bible, but the concept and the principle of the rapture is all through the Bible. And it's a principle that is real and it is true. So here's what I said on page 11 of the book. Prophecy culminates in the bodily resurrection of the saints that we call the rapture. See, it's a bodily resurrection. It is a precious jewel because it is our blessed hope. The word rapture is not in the Bible, but words such as Trinity and demon do not appear either. Yet they describe important doctrines of our faith. Knowing the origin of the word rapture will help to open your understanding to the word. So why do we use the word rapture? Here's what rapture means. Rapture is derived from the Latin word rapturo. The Greek word in the New Testament is harpazo, they say, and the English uses the two words caught up. In other words, rapturo in Latin, harpazo in Greek, caught up in English are all the same principle or the same concept. Are you with me? So when somebody talks about the rapture, they're talking about or the harpazo or the word rapturo. They're all talking about the same event. It's kind of like talking about a car. You can call a car an automobile. You can call it your ride. You can call it your vehicle. Guess what? We're all talking about the same thing. A car, vehicle, automobile. It's all the same thing, isn't it? Rapturo, harpazo, caught up. It's all the same event. It's all the same thing, right? Let's go a little further here. Rapturo literally means to be taken out of the way. The word rapturo in Latin, to be taken out of the way, caught up, right? To be gathered or caught away. Harpazo and caught up also mean the same. Another term that the Bible uses is the word translated. You ever read the word translated in your Bible? This is interesting. Translated is used 3 times in Scripture, and it has the same meaning as caught up, or harpazo, or rapturo. Translated means this. It means to be conveyed from one place to another. That's what the word translated means. 3 times in your New Testament, the word translated is used. What is he talking about? It's the same word for the word rapture. So let me give you a few verses here with the word translated. Colossians chapter 1, verse 13, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. That word translated is the same word as the word we use rapture or caught up, caught away. Hebrews 11:5 is the second place. By faith, Enoch was translated that he should not see death. Now, you could put the word rapture. That Enoch was raptured. He was translated. He was taken from one place to another. That's what the word rapture is. And he was not found because God had translated him. For before his translation, he had this testimony that he pleased God. Translated is used three times in two verses, and it is the biblical word used in reference to the rapture. Since rapture is the word we are most familiar with today, even though it's not a Bible word, we'll stick with the word rapture, and we use the word rapture in the book because it's the word that we've all become accustomed to. But I wanted you to understand the word translated is probably the more biblical word that we all should have used. But so caught up is used several places here, and I'm not gonna read all these for you. But in the book, I talk about the word caught up. I give you all the places in the Bible the words caught up are used, and they're all talking about somebody being taken somewhere, but not necessarily a bodily rapture. But we certainly can understand that the word caught up means the rapture, and the rapture means to be caught up. So don't let people get under your skin. You know, people come along, well, the word rapture is not in the Bible. Well, great. We know that. We know that. That's fine. The word car is not in the Bible, but we believe in cars, right? So don't let this stuff flush to you. You know, the rapture is a biblical event, being caught up. Jesus Christ is coming for the church. He's coming for the saints. He's going to take us out of here, and we're all going to be caught up. I hope that you know the Lord, my friend. I hope that sometime in your life you've put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ and that you're on your way to heaven. If you haven't, call the number on the screen. Ask somebody to help you. They could send you some literature, or somebody would be glad to talk to you over the phone and tell you how to be born again. Because if you're not born again, he's not coming for you. When that trump of God sounds, you'll be left behind. And that'll be a sad day for you, my friend. And we don't want that for you. We want you to be born again. We want you to be one of the saints. He's coming for the saints. If you're not one of the saints, and by the way, a saint is simply a born-again person. And so he's coming for the born-again saints. Make sure that you're one of them. Make sure you know the Lord as your Savior. And friends, keep looking up.